Hi, and welcome to WAW Aftermath.
How hard is that, Gabby?
I'm sitting next to you. It's hard.
I'm the Triple X Tyrannosaurus of Sex, Buck DeRoss, the number one contender, and just all-around good guy. Got to do everything around here.
Uh-huh.
We are 1 week from the anniversary of WAW. I am excited, as you can tell.
There's no telling, Buck. You have to explain that to people. Okay. You have such a plain expression on your face.
Well, let's just get the show going. What's going on?
Let's go.
Taking a peek.
Take a peek.
Welcome to WAW Aftermath. Tonight's opening contest is a four-person sudden death match. And it's scheduled for one fall. The time limit, 15 minutes.
15 minutes!
Entering first, from Lynnfield, Massachusetts, he is the hand of Noxus, Derek Conway!
Is it what?
And shepherds we shall be, for thee, my lord, for thee. Power hath descended forth from thy hand.
Therefore
we swiftly carry out thy command. So we shall flow ever forth to thee, and teeming with souls shall it ever be.
In nomine patri, et fili,
Spiritus Sancti.
Entering second, from Manchester, New Hampshire, Hawk! Henry III, from Mobile, Alabama, it's the good old boy, Troy Gumbo!
Entering
four, we have the WAW Pure Wrestling Champion. Hailing from Windsor, Ontario, Canada. He is the Canadian Grandmaster at Arms.
Oh, God.
Morgan Kennedy Kilmerdock, MKK!
Shot bright, the trigger cries. I just wonder what we've got.
Got the skirt on.
I heard he was a flagellist.
Hey, gentlemen. Keith, ring the bell.
That one went right over my head.
I'll explain to you later, bud.
All right. I don't care. So forearm shots been traded by everybody.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Double
what is going on?
With Hawk and Conway.
It's a human demolition derby in there.
Whoa.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, I thought we were smashed to the ring.
MJ rolled out of that one.
Yeah.
No, move it.
He gets to the pen just like you kick him right in the back of the head. That Conway's all class.
Oh, Garbo, up and
dumping him out like the piece of trash he is.
Double clothesline by Hawk. Garbo, up and over. Double clothesline by Garbo. Conway and MKK trying to get up. Garbo back at Hawk. Hawk slinging him off the ropes. Oh, elbow.
I've completely lost track of what's going on here. It's just a mess.
Okay, open your eyes.
There's people running everywhere.
Oh! Hawk's back, Garbo.
Oh, no.
Nope. I'm not exactly sure what they call this, but I don't think that's the Maytag Agitator.
Is that what that is?
I think so. I may have invented that one, but hey.
Hawk finally found a use for MKK.
It's
the most effective he's ever been. Been used as a weapon. And here comes Hawk. Too slow for Conway, though.
Conway kicking him in the bread basket, as Mr. Epic used to call it.
Oh! Bread in that basket.
Oh, that wasn't the bread basket. That was
you gotta break your leg doing that.
Don't you call that move dust move?
That's when I do it.
That's when you do it. See?
When it's him, it's just that's the I'll boot.
See, that should tell you something when I know your moves.
It's because I'm a star, baby.
Here
we go.
KK's got Garbo.
Hurry up and get up there. Hurry up. He took too long.
Hawk pushes Conway off the rope. Swing and miss.
Over the border.
Wow. And I would say that was a trip to Disney. Ha.
Hawk is fired up tonight.
Clothesline by Hawk. Scoop slam.
Scoop slam. Drops it right on the big empty head of Garbo.
And here I was thinking he was busy from wrestling.
That's all right, as long as you get somebody.
Whoa.
There's no friends in this match.
That looked like it hurt.
I hope it hurt everybody.
Oh.
What is he doing?
I don't know what MKK is doing.
Yep, he's up to something, I can tell. As long as it involves Garbo, I don't mind.
Oh!
MKK cutter, no, reversed.
Oh! And Conway kicking MKK in the stuff. Whoa!
Splat.
That looked like a rag.
Ain't getting away that easy. Ain't getting out that easy.
Oh,
man.
What would you call that?
That's just Conway imposing his will on him. Uh-oh. Pull through.
Schoolboy, right? Is that what that was?
No, it was a sunset. Whatever. That's a jackknife pin. Neither effective. This is going to end it right here. He's got him right here. Backslide. The backslide got him.
Your winner, Troy Garbo.
We'll be right back. Let me tell you something, Conway. You know, a ruling has finally been handed down from the board of directors regarding your actions against Rocco and his pregnant fiancée, Stelina. Yeah, you did. So in addition to that, plus this little hissy fit that is uncalled for.
I kicked out at two. My shoulder wasn't even down. You can't see. You're Mexican and you can't see.
You're clearly mentally unstable to be in this ring.
Wait, I'm unstable?
Yeah.
Of all the people in the locker room.
So what I think I'm going to do is give you a little break from next week's 15-year anniversary show.
What? Get an anniversary show in a Conway?
Oh, I'm serious. Yeah, I know it is.
You can't do this.
Do you want to push it? I can extend your suspension if you want.
Conway, don't do anything you regret.
You want to suspend me for the anniversary show?
Yeah.
That's what you want to do?
Yeah.
You're going to pay hard. You're going to pay hard, I swear.
We'll see.
That guy makes me absolutely sick throwing his weight around like that. How could he do that to Conway?
He's going
to
pay
How
hard.
How much love anniversary without that short game? Come on.
Red guy, you're going to pay hard, I swear to God.
Bullshit.
Anyhow.
Bullshit.
Speaking of next year's 15-year anniversary. Next week, we're going to see a match that is 5 years in the making. Next year, we're going to see the Hall of Famer, Sin, go one-on-one with Christian Sane. We're also going to see next week Michael James defending his WAW championship against several former WAW champions.
What's he talking about?
I'm not going to say who. You guys are going to have to show up to find out who he's defending against.
You didn't tell me. I'm the number one contender.
The same goes for Morgan Kennedy Kilmarnock. He'll be defending his Pure Wrestling Championship against other former Pure Wrestling Champions. Again, you'll just have to show up next week to find out who he's going to be defending against.
Well, thanks for filling us in.
And also, other matches for next week's anniversary show will be made tonight. But as far as tonight goes, Flax, get out here right now. We want Flax. We want Flax.
Uh-oh.
We want Flax.
He's got him
going.
We want
Flax.
They do.
We want Flax.
For weeks, that's what I heard. Even after I threw my mask off, punched him in the face, and backhanded Trixie. And quit this place. I still heard, we want Flax.
We want Flax.
So then at Hellbound I gave you Flax, and then those chants turned into, why Flax, why? For those that weren't here that couldn't afford the $2 to get in, of course it was.
Humongous.
I tried to make history by helping Delilah become the first ever vixen to win the WAW championship, and it didn't come to fruition. Then I got in an altercation with that man over there in that bow tie.
That troublemaker.
And then I was hit in the face, fire fisted by Michael James, thrown out into the cold by Steve Aleutian, and I said I was going to sue every single person here. And then Flax got a phone call from the mysterious board of directors, and they said, Flax, why don't you come to Aftermath and speak your mind? I have a dream that one day WAW will be run the way it's supposed to be, with fun and shenanigans for everyone.
Yeah!
guys know.
Not with this guy in charge.
It's way better when I was in charge.
So, if the board really wants me to speak my mind, do you people have any idea how disrespectful it is for us to come out here week after week, month after month, year after year, put our bodies on the line, and you can't even look up from your cell phones to pay attention? Do you guys have any idea how disrespectful that is? Do you have any idea how hard it is to be a referee, a commentator, or a performer and hear, you got a dumb hyena laugh. Shut up. We got a man in the back there who's been coming to WW for years, Abdullah, for years. And I thought that you were a secret terrorist taking notes, waiting for the best possible time to blow us all up. But you've been in that crowd for so long, you know this country's going in the toilet. Humongous, you smell so bad. That's not a joke, it's the truth. Pete LaBrie, how many S's are silent in Des Moines? I'll give you a hint. All of them. I hate the stupid fans. I hate the stupid people in the back. I hate the stupid commentators. Hey. I hate Pete's stupid mic skills. And I hate Red Guy's stupid face.
Wow. Yes, sir.
Are you finished out here?
No. Is he ever done?
Maybe. I'm here for a while. I'm here until I don't need to be here anymore. They asked me to come here, so that's what I'm doing. I'm speaking my mind, Red Guy.
Do you have any other reason for being out here?
Do I have any other reason for being out here? Let's see. Saturday night, Manchester, New Hampshire. What's next week? The 15th anniversary show. Oh my God, I have a great idea. Next week, for the first time, for the last time, Flax versus Red Guy. And when I win, I become the president of WAW. And if you show up, I'm gonna make you do all the things you made me do. Referee, commentary, shine Carnage's head, brush MKK's shoulder hair. Anything I can think of.
No. No. See, why should I put my job on the line when I have everything to lose and you don't?
Guy, I'll tell you what. Name it. Name it. Whatever you want, Red Guy. Whatever you want on the line. Name it.
Anything?
Anything. I'm all ears.
Oh, wait. You already got rid of it.
Okay. Okay. I'll tell you what. I'll put my job on the line. You put your Hall of Fame contract on the line. So that way, when I win, you get to keep being my bitch just like you have been for the last 6 months.
That's just cold. That was cold.
You feel that draft coming in?
You guys think that was funny? You shouldn't even talk. I don't know what's worse, the fact that you have your kids fall asleep to lullabies of ICP, or that you bring them to a show like this, a violent, family, entertaining show like this.
Key word was family, Flats.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Well.
Justin! Oh, buddy. Oh, I smacked him in the head.
plastic bottle.
Black, hey.
He doesn't deserve it.
Let me tell you something. You want to come out here and run your mouth about the Juggalos?
Yes, I do.
They happen to be some of our most passionate and loyal WAW fans. And if you're so eager to get back in this ring, you want to challenge me to a match. You want to go. You want to wrestle. I'll tell you what. Why don't you take on Jay Chill tonight?
I have nothing to prove to Jay Chill. I'm a Hall of Famer. I can come and go as I please. The only reason I'm here is to speak my mind and challenge you to next week. Why do I want to wrestle Jay Chill tonight?
Are you scared?
Am I scared? Am I, Flax, scared? I've held almost every title I could, and I'm... Yeah, you know what? I am scared of catching something when I step into the ring with you.
Now is the time to choose. Die and be free of pain, or live and fight your sorrow.
Flax, you haven't answered any of my calls. You haven't answered any of my texts. About Hellbound.
Yeah, I left my phone in my other pants.
You don't have other pants. We both know this. Okay. But you know what? You were mass referee. You tried to screw over Michael James.
Tried
to help me win.
I tried. Didn't work.
I'm a little disappointed in you, but you know what? You're my best friend, and I know you have my best interests at heart.
Aww, BFF for life.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
But then there's you. You know what? If you don't want to fight, Flack, well, all right. But you mean I could always... Jay Chill, where do you think you're going?
You don't want to wrestle Jay Chill. He's gonna sit on you and crush you. No. Do not.
Yeah.
No.
Did you see what I did in the main event?
Yeah.
I took a fire fist to the face.
Yeah.
You look like you've taken one too many fiery burritos to there.
Whoa!
But come on, Jay Chill, let's go.
This song's called Too Cold, but she is too cold right now.
Looks like
the
little
missus
wants some chili. I don't like it.
I would.
Oh,
no, you do.
Let's go
chili.
I say hold this.
Let's go chili.
About both of you.
Let's go chili.
Yeah. Wow.
I'm sick of your mouth, and you sit all day. Hurry up.
Oh, look at that guy doing the job for you.
I'm
about to say, not just compete.
Flex, I'm a little confused.
We got an answer, my guy. You and I have a 15th anniversary show.
Get in the ring.
It's 2-on-1. Could find any clowns putting Jay Chill's corner? And there's like seven in each car, so. Maybe somebody.
Same crowd that was rotten flags back as rooting for Jay Chill.
Yes! Oh, yeah! All right.
Almost had him, Flax. Almost had him.
Hold him back, ref. Hold him back. Oh, my Lord.
That only happened because he didn't have adequate quick time to stretch. See what happens? He didn't have warp his muscles.
Okay, hey, I'm in. All right.
He's not going to try this again, is he?
Flax is rethinking the whole Jay Chill.
He needs to rethink his strategy if he's going to try this.
Breadbasket by Flex.
What do you say? Ask him right now. What do you say?
Jay Chill! Jay Chill!
swing in some leather. Oh, God. Oh, now he's riled him up. He's got to tag out.
Betty's having chest pain. She'll hit him hard.
Nope. She'll pick him right up where he left off.
Ooh.
He's not a goat anymore. I was fooled this entire time. I thought he was actually a goat. Apparently, it was just a mask this whole time. This is what Jay Shill wanted. He wanted a handicap match.
Oh!
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
What was that?
That was the end of Jay Shill is what we saw. Jesus. Head first, right on that apron.
I'm going to use all my strength. I have my strength. You have
my strength.
You ain't getting back in the ring. I'm going to pull you back up.
I hope they're both wearing hernia belts. I saw dust come off of that wall.
No, that was Jay Chill.
Okay, in a small way, I think that made him happy.
This ain't so bad.
All right, that made Chill happy.
Well, actually, he's got weeks. That's it. That's it. Come on, he held that cup. That's like 9 7/8.
Really, Buck?
Yeah.
You can really count that way?
Make a wish.
I counted it myself.
1, 2, 2.
Oh!
Dirty. Dirty.
I can only imagine the wish Jill's making now.
He's wishing he had a vagina instead of balls. You might.
He can't hit you. There's Stango in his ears.
Well, I'm kicking him in the shoulder. Kind of poking the barrel of the stick there.
Oh, man.
She's brutal.
Pin the level. 1, 2, 3.
Oh.
2.
It's out of the way.
Loose from the leg drop.
What do you look like?
Hit that whole building.
It's out of 2. Delilah's not. It's not like she's not trying.
She just basically just fell on him after a somersault. Not that devastating.
Well, Flax is coming back in the ring.
Come on, Delilah. 2. Make sure she's out of the ring. Make sure that she's getting out of the ring. 4. Get out of the ring. Get out of the ring. Thank you, Delilah. I see that your leg's a little hurt.
Oh.
So maybe I should stop kicking it.
Oh.
Maybe not. Greatest submission ever.
Oh no! Oh no!
Oh!
Whoa! I thought he snuck that one out.
Dazed and confused, but I'm not so sure that was the greatest submission ever.
The small package. It's me.
I'm not going there.
Yeah, that's
too easy.
Oh! I seriously never thought I would see this side of Flax or Delilah.
I knew they're both scumbags from day one.
Double clothesline by Jay Chill.
Came through like a
both
truck.
Delilah and Flax. Flax is out of the ring. Delilah's holding on to her knee. Uh-oh. Oh, Delilah's out at 2.
She's hurt.
Holding on to her knee.
You gotta close on someone pretty high to blow her knees out.
Jay Chill's got Flax back in the ring.
I think what ain't got match.
Black's looked a little concerned.
What's he going for here?
Whoa!
Oh, no.
That's not cool. Uh-oh.
No way. No way. Icebreaker by Chill.
Is Black alive up there?
So I got a little bit of news for you regarding this match that you proposed for next week.
Yes!
Next week, you and I will go one-on-one.
Yeah!
But there's a catch.
There's always a catch. I'm usually the pitcher, but go on.
You see, downstairs just now, while I was enjoying watching Jay Chill kick your ass. I also made a little phone call.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
So next week, in our match, there will be a special guest referee.
If you say Trixie, I call
the end. Oh, please let it be Trixie. I'll backhand her one more time.
It's not Trixie.
Okay.
Next week, the special guest referee in our match will be the same man whose match I called at Legacy this year. One of my best friends. Next week, the special guest referee in our match will be Kevin Chaos.
No way.
What? Kevin?
That sounds crooked. That sounds crooked.
The guest referee.
Go downstairs and break something. There's a lot of expensive stuff up here.
All right. Well, now we're
finally got rid of Flax.